A very good morning to all of you guys. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So in today's video, we are going to discuss about the new mission that Prime Minister has launched. What is that new mission? That new mission is on edible oil. So in order to increase the production of edible oil and reduce our import dependence on other countries in the field of oil, this mission has been launched. So what are the details related to this mission and what kind of questions can be framed out of this mission? These are the things that we are going to discuss in this video. Not only this, we will also be discussing about the World Biofuel Day. Also, we will be discussing about the new bilateral maritime exercise that India has conducted for the first time with a country in the Gulf region. So all of this we will be discussing in this video. So stay tuned till the end of this video. Before beginning, if you haven't subscribed, then do subscribe and hit the bell notification. And you can also join this Telegram group where you will get the PDF of this session for free. So guys, here is the National Mission on Edible Oil, and particularly this mission will cater to palm oil. Now, while covering this mission, I will be telling you from which statement or from which fact what kind of question can be framed. So the first thing that we have here is the target. What are the targets under this national mission on edible oil? So the mission will ensure self-sufficiency in edible oil production. Under the mission, the government will ensure that farmers get all facilities from quality seeds to technology to promote farming to produce palm oil and other oil seeds. So these are two very basic statements which are very basic in nature that you don't need to put any extra effort in memorizing these statements, and no question can be framed out of these two statements. The next point here is very important. In February 2020, Commerce Minister had announced that this mission would aim to reduce import dependence from 60% to 45% by 2024 to 2025, by increasing the domestic oil production from 10.5 million tons to 18 million tons, which is a 70% growth target. It projected a 55% growth in oil production to 47.8 million tons. So there are so many amounts from which the question can be made. The first question is that what is the target of import reduction under this mission? So the target is to reduce the imports from 60% to 45% by 2024 to 2025. The next is how much oil production does this mission aim to achieve in India? Then the answer would be 18 million tons. So what would be the growth rate of oil production under this mission? So the growth rate would be 70%. The next thing is that what is the targeted oil seed production under this national mission on edible oil? Then the answer would be 47.8 million tons. What would be the growth rate, or what is the growth rate of oil seed production under this mission? So the growth rate is 55%. So these many questions are being formed from this one single statement only. Now remember that this statement was made in February 2020, and till now, till the time the final version of this mission has been launched, no new update on these facts has been given by the government. So we are taking it as the final. But if there is a new update regarding this mission or regarding any of these targets, then I will be letting you know on this channel through the morning tales only. So you need not to worry about it. Just pay attention to the facts that are mentioned here. The next most important fact here is the budget and the tenure. 11,000 crores over 5 years. Okay. So clear question ban sakta, what is the outlay of this national mission on edible oil, oil palm, and this target or this mission will be operational for how many years? So at present, 5 years. Moving on to the next thing that can be of importance for you in your upcoming NABARD examination. So what was the scheme before this mission? So before this mission, we had National Mission on Oil Seeds and Oil Palm, and it was later merged with National Food Security Mission. So the question that can be framed out of this news is that before the launch of this mission, National Mission on Oil Seeds and Oil Palm was in operation, which was later merged with one of the central government scheme. You have to name that scheme. Then in that case, the name of that scheme would be National Food Security Mission. Okay. Production of oil seeds in India. So what is the current production level? According to Agriculture Ministry, oil seed production had grown by 35% from 27.5 million tons in 2014 to 15 to 37.3 million tons by 2020 to 2021. So direct question banega yahan se that what is the oil seed production in 2020 to 2021. The next point here is the oil seed acreage increased by 8.6% in the 6 year period 2014 to 15 to 20 to 21, but the yields rose more than 20%. Okay, so the fact based questions, from the fact based news or statements, direct questions are made. Therefore, I always tell you to memorize the digits as it is, memorize the facts, because facts are important and direct questions are made from the facts. In statement based questions like these, the questions can be tricked, but whenever the facts are there, questions are normally simple and direct. Okay, let's move on to the next slide of this mission. So imports, as I told you that this mission has been launched in order to reduce India's import dependence. So how much do we import? Itna kitna import karte hain hum oils mein, that we need to have an 11,000 crore worth of mission. So let's see that. India produces less than half of the roughly 2.5 crore tons of edible oil that is consumed annually. So basically we consume this much of oil and half of it is produced in India. It imports the rest. More than 50% is the import of India. So the rest of the oil is imported in the form of palm oil from Indonesia and Malaysia. So there was a huge controversy regarding the palm oil customs. So you need to know that Indonesia and Malaysia are the two major, or Mekongi, world's largest producer of palm oil. So palm oil industry mein, if there is a country which is humongous, then it is Indonesia and Malaysia. Next, soil oil is imported from Brazil and Argentina. Sunflower oil is from Russia and Ukraine. So these kinds of edible oils are imported in India. Next is, India's vegetable oil imports have increased to 1.5 crore tons from 40 lakh only 2 decades ago. So this is clearly due to the population increase as well. Next, imports could reach 20 million by 2030, boosted by a growing population with higher incomes. So that was all about this National Mission for Edible Oils, wherein I told you about the targets, I told you about the budget and the tenure, the need. Why do we need to have such a kind of initiative? All of it we have discussed, and what kind of questions can be framed out of this mission has already been discussed by me. But still, if you have any kind of doubt in understanding this mission or any kind of anomalous information that you found, then you can mention it in the comment section below. Okay, moving on to the next question. Al Mohad Al Hind. Hind, this is Hind. 2021 exercise is the maiden bilateral exercise between India and which nation? So I told you in the beginning itself that it is a Gulf nation. So now can you guess which nation is this? Tunisia, Iran, Jordan, Kuwait, Saudi Arabia. The right answer here is Saudi Arabia. So this exercise was conducted between Saudi Arabian and Indian Navy, and INS Kochi participated in this exercise. Your task is to tell me that which company has built this INS Kochi, because this is an indigenously built stealth destroyer. So you have to tell me, it's the naval ship is built indigenously. So you have to tell me that which company has built this INS Kochi. Now, recently, Zayed Talwar, Bilateral exercise was also conducted by India with UAE. Okay, so do remember this thing. So basically, after completing Zayed Talwar, this ship went to Saudi Arabia. Then they conducted this exercise also. Achha, isse you need to know that last year when M.M. Naravane, the army chief, went to Saudi Arabia, he announced that armies of both the countries will also conduct a bilateral army exercise by the end of 2021. But still now, we don't have any information related to that. But you need to know that army is also planning to conduct a bilateral exercise with Saudi Arabia. So that is the information that you should be aware of. And do not forget to mention the answer in the comment section below. Who heads the India Internet Governance Forum? So this is headed by Anil Kumar Jain, the CEO of National Internet Exchange of India. Now guys, let me tell you that UN Internet Governance Forum is the apex level forum which undertakes the activity related to internet governance. Okay, and this is the Indian arm of this UN Internet Governance Forum. As we have Indian branches of various international organizations, this is one of its kind. Now remember that for the first time, this forum is going to be conducted in the month of October 2021. Here, the thing that you need to understand is that this forum is not only an event. We take forum as an event as well as forum as a committee. So this forum is not only an event. This is a committee. I hope that you are understanding what I'm trying to teach you. This India Internet Governance Forum is basically a panel that has been created, and this panel includes 12 members, and all the head of this panel is this Anil Kumar Jain, who is the CEO of National Internet Exchange of India. Now, what is the purpose of creating this? The purpose is to administer the internet activities in India so that it can be helped, or internet can be used for digital governance and towards sustainable growth and Atmanirbhar Bharat. Also need to remember that this forum will have a theme. What is the theme? The theme is Inclusive Internet for Digital Bharat. Inclusive Internet for Digital Bharat. So basically this forum has been established in order to use internet for attaining the purpose of Digital Bharat, Digital India. So this is the theme of this forum. Do remember the theme as well. Who has been appointed as the ambassador of RBI kehta hai, which is a public awareness campaign of RBI against digital banking frauds. So the right answer is Neeraj Chopra. I think I don't feel any kind of need of explaining anything related to Neeraj Chopra. All of the facts that can become a question in your examination have already been discussed. Now guys, the question that I'm going to ask you is that when did RBI launch the RBI Kehta Hai campaign? You have to mention the answer in the comment section. Okay, this is a very important question guys. What is the theme of World Biofuel Day 2021 of Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas? So first of all, the very first thing is that it is observed on August 10, and on the same day we also have World Lion Day. This year there was no theme of World Lion Day. It was just the date that you need to know. The next thing is, what is the theme of the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas? So the theme is Biofuels for Sustainability and Rural Income. Now guys, this is the theme for the Indian Ministry. So India is observing this day under this theme. What is the theme of the globe? So the entire globe's theme is this: promotion of biofuels for a better environment. For example, there are certain days when UN decides its theme and India also decides its own theme. For example, in International Day, Yoga Day, on the day we have a UN decided theme which is accepted as the global theme, and we have our own theme as well. So in this case also we have two themes that we need to remember. First is the global theme and second is the Indian theme. Okay. Now, the next thing is that this day is observed to honor Sir Rudolf Diesel. So he is basically a German inventor who invented the diesel engine, and this day is observed to honor his invention. Okay, so this is the background fact that you need to know. The next thing about this World Biofuel Day is the target of India in relation to biofuels. So ethanol blending target 20% to be achieved by 2025, biodiesel mixing in diesel 5% by 2030. And remember, these targets are laid out by the National Biofuel Policy of 2018. Okay, so these targets are mentioned under this policy. Do remember these two targets. Now, recently what has happened is that the Commerce and Industry Minister Piyush Goyal has made a statement that India will be able to achieve the ethanol blending target, ethanol blending in petrol. So this target by 2023 to 2024. Okay, so guys, that is a statement. The official target is 20%. Until or unless we have something in the official paper, we cannot take it as the final statement. So just remember 20% by 2025. And also be aware that Commerce Minister has made such kind of a statement wherein the target is 2023 to 2024. And do not get confused between these 2 years. Okay. The next thing is that natural gas, we have a target of increasing the natural gas share in the energy mix to 15% by 2030. Approximately 6% is the contribution of natural gas in the energy mix at present. So we have a target to increase it to 15% by 2030. So this is just another target that I wanted to inform you about. So that was all about the World Biofuel Day. Next question is a very light question. So who is the brand ambassador of Cashify? Cashify, I hope that you know what this Cashify is. This is a platform where you can sell your electronic items and get cash in return. Basically, the payment for that. So Rajkumar Rao has been appointed as the ambassador of Cashify and he is the first ambassador. So that's why it is important. So guys, here the video ends. I hope that you have enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching it.